We have those non-deterministic finite state automaton, and we want to make a deterministic one from it. So if we are in the non-deterministic finite state automaton and we want to read an A, then we can go whether to Q1 or to Q2, and we don't really know where we are because if you guys have the transition definition and we are in Q0 and reading an A, then we don't go into another state, but we go into a set of states, which is Q1, Q2. And we don't really know in which one we are, but we know exactly that we are in the set of states. And how we do it and when we convert it, first we have our start state. And if we are in Q0 and we read an A, we can go whether to Q1 or to Q2, or I colored it for you. And that we fuse into an only arc into a state. I could name it Q5 or Q whatever or something, but to make it clear, I name it Q1. Two. So that is the union of Q1 and Q2. So now, if we are in the state or we are in Q1, Q2, we have to now look at all possible transitions. So from Q1 with an A, we can go to Q4, and from Q2 with an A, we can go to Q3, because if we read a word with one A, then we don't know whether we are in Q1 or Q2. And if we read another A, we could either be in Q4 or in Q3. So we add another arc where we fuse Q3 and Q4. And because one of that is a final state, or if at least one of them is a final state, then you make the whole new state a final state. So now we have another possibility. We could from those Q1, Q2, we have those B that we can read, but we don't know, we don't have an B arc from Q1. So if we started here and we read a word with an A, then we don't know whether we are in Q1 or Q2. But if a B comes afterwards, then the only possibility is this arc, and then we know exactly that we are in Q2. So I add from this Q1, Q2, I add another arc. And I don't care that I didn't know before in which one of that I was, but if I read a B now, then I know that I only can be in Q2 now with a B. So if we are in those Q2, then well, we have those, yeah, we have only one arc left, so one possibility. So if we read an A from Q2, from this Q2, if we read an A, we go to Q3. With an A. And if we are in this Q2 or in this Q2 and we read a B, then we again go into Q2. So this loop stays the same. So we have another possibility. We have an A. No. If we are in those union set of Q3, Q4, then we can have yeah, we may can read another letter. For example, we can read A. And from Q if you are in Q3, you can't read an A, But if you are in Q4, you can read an A. So again, if you read one A, you don't know if you are in Q1 or Q2. And you read another A, you don't know if you are in Q3 or Q4. But if you read another A, then the only possibility to go on is with this arc. So I add another arc. And this goes to Q1. So, and we are not ready yet, because Q1 has other transitions possible. Because from Q1 you can take this arc, and that is again not the same as Q3, Q4, although there is already a 4 in it. Because if you are in Q1 and you take the transition from to Q4, then you exactly know that you are in Q4. And this is the final state. So you see, those Q4 and those Q3 are not the same as those Q3, 4, because this is a union state with both possibilities, and this Q4 has only the possibilities of this Q4, so that they are not the same, and I have to add it as a new state. And from this Q4, or from this Q4, we can take another A arc to Q1, and we already have a Q1 here, and then we can just add the arc from Q4 to Q1. And we are done.